is a good number. Now, I don't always read everything in my reading list, but you know, it's a good goal to have. I do tend to read most of the books on my reading list, but this time around, 7 seemed like a good number, and it seems like a goal that I can complete. So, I'm someone who tends to pick up quite a few books every time I go thrifting. So that's why I like creating lists, because, you know, I don't want to leave any books behind or neglected. So the books that I'm going to be sharing with you today, I have not read them, so I can't really give you my thoughts on them. Sometimes I add books to my reading list that I have read, and I just, you know, I want to read them again because I really enjoyed it, or I read it but I didn't really grasp it, so I, you know, I want to reread it. But this time around, these books are new to me. So I will link down below the last one that I did, the very first one that I did, and it was my summer reading list. You guys seem to really enjoy that. I really did like the format of that one. It was more of like a bird's eye view, just showing the books, not my face. And I liked that setup. However, you know, it's been a while since I filmed, and I really wanted to get some videos out, so I figured, you know, I'm just going to film it like this instead of having to change my whole entire setup and all that jazz. So, okay. The first book is this subjects. But it seems like a very thought-provoking book. And I would definitely say that this is a YA. But I love the cover. Something about it is simplistic, yet eye-catching. Says here, a disturbing, heartbreaking finale that retains a touch of hope. Thank you. Thank you. was it a murder or self-defense? For nearly a decade, the shooting and its aftermath reverberated throughout this hauntingly beautiful city of moss-hung oaks and shaded squares. John Burns sharply observed, a suspenseful and witty narrative reads like a thoroughly engrossing novel, and yet it is a work of nonfiction. Brent skillfully interweaves a hugely entertaining first-person account of life in this isolated remnant of the Old South with the unpredictable twists and turns of a landmark murder case. It is a spellbinding story peopled by a gallery of remarkable characters. The well-bred society ladies of the Merry Woman's Card Club. The turbulent young redneck gigolo. The hapless recluse who owns a bottle of poison so powerful it could kill every man, woman, and child in Savannah. The aging and profane Southern Belle who is the soul of pampered self-absorption. The uproariously funny black drag queen. The acerbic and arrogant antique stealer. The sweet talking piano playing con artist. Young blacks dancing. The minute of the black debutante ball and maneuver. The voodoo priestess who works her magic in the graveyard at midnight. These and other Savannahians act as a Greek chorus, with Brent revealing the alliances, hostilities, and intrigues that thrive in a town where everyone knows everyone else. Midnight in the Garden of Good and Evil, a Savannah story, is a sublime and seductive reading experience, brilliantly conceived and masterfully written. This enormously engaging portrait of a most beguiling southern city is certain to become a modern classic. And this came out in 1993. So this is actually non-fiction. So this is what some people have to say about this book. Forceful, clear, gripping, Midnight in the Garden of Good and Evil is the best non-fiction novel since In Cold Blood, and a lot more entertaining. Since Brent's book has everything going for it. Snobism, ruthless power, voodoo, local color, and a totally evil aestheticism. I read it till dawn. Edmund Witt. So, the cover is like of a statue of a woman or a girl. Shallow bowls. So it's like a bird bath kind of statue. And it looks like the statue is amongst a graveyard, which looks kind of creepy. Thank you. voice and audience with the highly reclusive Adolf Hitler at the Victor's Ball in Tokyo. Yao, a former death camp prisoner, has witnessed too much suffering, and the five wolves tattooed on her arm are a constant reminder of the loved one she's lost. The resistance has given Yao one goal: win the race and kill Hitler. A survivor of painful human experimentation, Yao has the power to skin shift and must complete her mission by impersonating last year's only female racer, Adele Wolf. This deception becomes more difficult when Felix, Adele's twin brother, and Luca, her former love interest, enter the race and watch Yao's every move. But as Yao grows closer to the other competitors, can she be as ruthless as she needs to be to avoid discovery and stay true to her mission? From the author of The Walled City comes a fast-paced and innovative novel that will leave you breathless. This book seems like nothing else. making a deal. My nose sees she can have the freedom she's always dreamed of, if she's willing to part with the terrible secrets of her past. Dark, breathtaking, and ultimately hopeful, Stephanie Oak's debut novel is a harrowing, poetic page-turner and a book you are unlikely to ever forget. Stephanie Oak's. So, in the back here, it says, "He watches me a moment, and I wonder if he can read in my expression that I will never tell him the truth. I'll give him a version of events, a half-truth, but I haven't told anyone what happened in those smoke-filled moments in January when I stood over the prophet's body and watched him